So today, we're going to actually talk about the GTR version 1.0 and the M5 version 1.0. And what I'm going to do today is actually show you how to utilize the fans on the M5 after we connect them together. Now, keep in mind, I'm going to put all of the affiliated links in the description. And I purchased all of the equipment with my own money, and no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. So the first step to integrating the GTR and the M5 together is to use what's known as a ribbon cable. So the ribbon cable is actually notched on both sides. I'll let you figure that out, but what I'll do right now is I'll actually connect it so you can see. So the first notch, you just push down on the one side, and then you're going to take the other side and you're going to connect it with the notch connector like so. And this will integrate the two boards together. That's all you need to do to set up the communication between the GTR and the M5. So we're going to actually be doing the fans over here. So we need to understand where the fans are located between the GTR version 1.0 and the M5 version 1.0. So I'm going to refer to these in G code format. So this is P0, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, and P7. So it's basically eight fans that we have access to between the two boards. Now, I'm going to skip showing you how to do it on the GTR because I'm pretty sure after you see this, you'll be able to figure it out. But what I've done on here is I've actually marked the positive side for voltage with a little bit of red highlighter so that we can see it. So that will be a key so that we can use our actual connection. And in this case, I have red on one side and black on the other for ground. So I'm going to place that in P3. And then over in P7, I'm going to do exactly the same thing. And I'll show you why in a moment this is important. So there we go. So the next thing we need to do is prepare this to actually receive firmware. But we need to do it through the SD drive. So we have to pop this out and then place this in the micro SD adapter. So I'm going to pick this up and I'm going to place it in here like so. Then I'm going to place this in my computer and you may hear a beep. And then I'm going to take this jumper and remove it and place it over on the next two set of pins. And this will be for actually loading the firmware. So it'll be off 5 volts on your USB cable. So to start with, like always, I'm going to show you the SD card and how it's got the current firmware on it, being firmware.cur in all capital letters. But I'm going to switch over quickly to VS Code since I've already downloaded the Marlin firmware and extracted it. I'm going to load it. So I'm going to click over here on Explorer and then I'm going to go to Open Folder. Inside Open Folder, we have the downloaded Marlin that's been extracted, but it has a Marlin folder within. So you need to click on that, then select Folder. And while this is loading, let's look around here. So we've got our Marlin folder where all the functionality that we need to set this board up is residing. So we're going to click on the source folder and then we're going to go to the core folder. Inside the core folder, we're going to go to boards.h and we're going to search on GTR because that's our main board for communication. So we're going to press Control F and then we're going to type GTR. And then underscore, and that'll bring us to our board type. We're going to copy that. And once we copy that, we're going to make note of what our 32-bit processor is, because it says Cortex M4F. This is an ARM or STM32. That might be relevant in a second. So let's minimize the core for a moment, go over to our configuration.h and do a search on motherboard. And inside here, we're going to highlight the ramps configuration because this is the default. And we're going to paste what ours is. Now, the next thing we need to do is actually change our serial port from 0 to -1. And then we need to set up our actual fans to be used. Now, what I mean is, natively, they're usually enabled, but there's a problem inside this actual configuration file that we need to address. So we're going to go over to pins, and we're going to find the STM32 and see if we can find our actual board. So it's going to reside in one of these three, probably. So I'm going to open this, and inside here I'm going to look for the GTR. And apparently I don't see it. So I'm going to minimize that, go to the next one, and see if I see the GTR, which I do. So I'm going to click on that, and that brings up the pins file, which defines our printer board and the auxiliary M5 that connects to it. So as you can see, there are a lot of different settings here. They have limiting switches, and right now they have them all enabled, and these are the actual pinout numbers for us to actually connect to them. So it's basically a definition of how the board is laid out and how we can communicate. And as you can see, like for steppers, they do something like chip select. This says what the pin number is that we're trying to connect to. That's an addressing scheme for each one of the stepper drivers. And as you can see, there are many of them. But what we're interested in is fans. So we're going to have to scroll down a bit to find them. And let's see. Still not there, but here we are. So we have our fans. And right now it only has, what is it? Approximately 6 pins specified. There's probably a fan specified someplace else. But you can see this is fan 0, actually it's 7, or 8, pardon me. And you have fan 7, so that's 1 through 8. But we can't use the last fan right now because it has a comment that's in front of it. So we're going to remove the comment. This will enable us to use that fan. And then we'll go over to our... Actually, we have to save that real quick. We're going to go over to our platform.io.ini so we can configure this for a compile. And what I mean by that is when you click on platform.io, you can see that it's set up for a chipset or default environment of Mega 2560. Now, we're currently not using that, so we need to change it to what our chipset is. So we're going to do a control F, and we're going to search on GTR underscore, and you can see that we have the environment of BigTree underscore GTR underscore V1 underscore 0. We're going to copy that after highlighting it, and then we're going to scroll back to the top, and for our default environment, we're going to highlight that, and we're going to paste that that's our board type so that we can compile this. So over here, we have a couple of buttons. We have our platform build, which is known also as compile. And then we have our upload. So we're going to click on the checkbox to actually compile this. And this may take a moment. So we'll pick up right after this. So now that the compilation or build has completed, you can see that the BigTreeTech GTR version 1.0 is successful. It only took about 5 to 6 minutes on this computer. It may take longer on yours, but I'll show you how to figure that out in other tutorials. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to load the actual firmware onto your SD card. So I'm going to go to .pio, then I'm going to go to build, then GTR, and right click, and then go to reveal and explorer. Inside here, we're going to have to open up the GTR folder. And down here, we have firmware.bin. So we're going to right click on that. And then we're going to go to send to, and we're going to send it to our SD card. Now to check that it's arrived at its location, we can see in all lower cases, it says firmware.bin. So we know we're good there. So we're going to remove the drive so that we can insert it in the actual motherboard for the GTR. So now that we have the drive back out, we're going to take the actual SD card out and we're going to place this inside here and let it click in. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to connect the big side of the serial USB to the GTR board and we're going to attach the small side to our computer. This will allow the 5 volts to load, and you'll see a flashing light over here, which says that your firmware is loading. So off camera, I connected up the power leads, and as you can see, we have our voltage and our ground, and our voltage and our ground, and I've marked them both with red markings so I know where they are, so I do not accidentally damage my board. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to prepare this so that we can run off power versus the USB. So I'm going to disconnect this first. Then I'm going to move this jumper over to the next two pins and place it back down. I'm then going to connect my USB back. And as you can see, most of the board has no power now, but there is a light to let us know that we have the USB connected. The other thing that I want to point out is I had to change these connectors to ferrule connectors because I was too nervous with the ones provided. And I highly suggest that you use ferrule connectors. That way you don't accidentally cross wires because they're crimped inside a container. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to energize the system with actual power. And I'm going to connect it like so. And as you can see, now the board is actually energized with power. You want to avoid touching the board to one, not injure yourself, and two, not break the boards. So now to test it, what we're going to do is go to the print run directory and open up Pronterface. And we're going to use the connect button to connect to the GTR board. And as you can see now, it says printer is now online. So in order to actually test the fan, what we need to use is a G code. So we're going to do M106 space P. And this is where I was talking about P's earlier on. So it's P3 for our fan. And then I'm going to do another space, and I'm going to do S200 for the speed. And then I'm going to press enter and see what happens. And as you can see, the fan powers up. Now to change this so that we can actually do the other fan, we can do P7. And we can do S200 for the speed and press enter. And as you can see, now both fans are running. So what we're going to do next is turn off the fan by changing the 200 to a 0 for the eighth fan being P7 and press enter. And then we're going to do the same for the third fan, which is actually the fourth, which is going to be P3 S0. And press enter. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.